Well, joining us for the analytical part of this live coverage, we have Ken O'Keefe, former U.S. Marine, who joins us in the studios here in the capital, Tehran, and Rodney Martin, who's a former U.S. congressional staffer, who joins us from L.A., Los Angeles. Thank you, gentlemen. Ken O'Keefe, I'll start with you. This should, I would think, be a warning signal to some of the countries supporting the terrorists in the war in Syria, in particular the U.S., Turkey, and Saudi Arabia.
Yes, well, I hope actually that it's even more of a wake-up call for us to realize that we are ISIS, that the Western governments that are in bed with Saudi Arabia, who is the primary funder of ISIS, along with Qatar and other Gulf states, we not only provide the political cover and military assistance to Saudi Arabia while it slaughters innocent people in Yemen, but we also provide the cover for them to go ahead and do their dirty dealing with these psychopaths who are running around Syria and other parts of the world as well, Iraq. Let us remember that before the United States invaded Iraq, there was no al-Qaeda in Iraq. Look at it today. Let us also remember that when Gaddafi was in power in Libya, there was very little al-Qaeda. And in fact, now we look at it, and it's an absolute basket case full of these operatives. And we look to Syria as well as yet another example of where these problems were actually quite under control in terms of al-Qaeda. In fact, Bashar al-Assad was assisting the United States, this is all on record, in a very meaningful way. In fact, many of the tortures that were being carried out were being done by Bashar al-Assad, or at least his regime, in order to extract information from people that we were supposedly fighting. I believe that it is beyond any doubt for any sensible person to realize that not only is the United States providing the financial cover, military cover, political cover for these terrorists through our proxies, but we've also, in pure technical sense, provided the training for these people in Jordan and Turkey. Another one of our best friends has been shuttling these psychopaths across the country from Turkey into Syria for a long time now. So the idea that the West is actually fighting a war against ISIS is beyond ridiculous. So what we really need to do is start realizing the fact that we are ISIS, and the reason why our corrupt, treasonous governments are carrying out these policies is because they do not represent us. They represent the bankers, and the bankers make a hell of a lot of money off of war. And more importantly, as long as we're all fighting each other, as long as we're all not trusting each other, as long as we're all simply being played as pawns over and over, then they can maintain this tyrannical system of never-ending war. So this is really the wake-up call. What has happened in Paris is us. We are responsible through our corrupt governments for all of these policies, and even if these individuals who carried this out are not directly working for Mossad, CIA, ISIS, al-Qaeda, all the same thing, even if they did this organically of their own volition, believe me, that is exactly what our so-called governments want. That is what the policy that we've been fostering over and over. And quite frankly, if we're to look at ISIS, ISIS stands for Israeli Secret Intelligence Service. They never attack Israel, and that in itself also tells you a lot about who these individuals are.
Well, Rodney, Martin, perhaps some people might have thought and had doubts about any statements that are made regarding the Western support and some of the regional countries for these Daesh terrorists. But I'd like to get your reaction on the focus of this meeting prior to the announcement in Vienna, of which we just heard Foreign Policy Chief Federico Mogherini. And the focus was a warning that came from Iran and Russia that world powers that are going to be attending these talks need to compile a list of terrorist groups and, of course, then clarify the countries and which terrorist groups they're supporting in this war on Syria. That in itself is out of this world to try to figure out which countries are supporting what terrorist groups. So do you see then this being a link to what has happened in Paris, perhaps?
Well, first of all, let me say that I don't disagree with anything Mr. O'Keefe just said, but I think what's most important, well, and let me briefly comment on the situation of basically everybody naming, all the nations naming, basically Russia and Iran calling out the rest of the world, naming their bad guys and their boogeymen they've created, which now Russia and Iran and Syria are having to clean up. That's never, ever going to happen. And that's why consistently now in the Jewish and Zionist media in the United States, Russia has now been made a co-equal boogeyman and bad guy with ISIS and ISIL, which is the U.S.-created boogeyman. But what I think we need to be very careful with and watch very diligently that this event is not used to whip up Islamophobia, both in the West and especially in the United States. You'll have people in the United States saying, well, now, see, they attacked Paris. They're going to come over here next, and they're going to whip up anti-Islamic hysteria, and they're going to perpetuate this war on Islam. There was an attack in Paris. We don't have enough information right now to determine even if these, to determine anything, let alone if these attackers were Muslim we're hearing that they yelled Allah Akbar, but you know that anybody can develop a black ops and go in and create a problem, create an incident, so that they may create the co-equal solution. So I think we need to be very careful and not allow ourselves, meaning the public, get whipped up into hysteria like what happened in the preceding days after 9/11, and we see what a catastrophe in terms of national treasure in terms of human life in the Middle East, and the public policy since then as a result of that hysteria that was whipped up after 9/11 and the subsequent Islamophobia. Individuals carried out these attacks. We don't know anything about them yet, other than some witnesses said they heard them make some statements and they looked a certain way. And what we're hearing is that they were all neutralized and that their bodies are unidentifiable. There were 6 or 7 targets that were hit in a very, very methodical way. And this strikes me as being a special ops operation designed to create an incident to further an additional means. And so I think we really need to ask the right questions and not jump on the hysteria bandwagon at this point.
Well, some of the events there, Ken O'Keefe, that our guest Rodney Martin talks about in terms of Islamophobia being created again, or more policies to exercise against Muslims, well, maybe this is what the intent is behind these attacks. If there are any hands at play behind the scenes of some of the countries involved in this so-called war on terror.
Well, indeed, that's the case, and it's just more of the same now, isn't it? Now, I'm a non-Muslim, and I am angry at the way Muslims have been portrayed around the world. I have lived in Muslim lands, and I have experienced some of the greatest hospitality and generosity that you will ever experience. And yet Muslims in general are being associated with this monstrosity, this most recent monstrosity known as ISIS, which again I say is Israeli Secret Intelligence Service, and also Al-Qaeda previous to that, Al-Nusra Front. All of these things are intended to smear Islam as a whole, 1.8 billion people on this planet, to associate them with this sort of madness, when in fact it is us in the West that are creating this stuff, funding it, very much protecting it. In fact, America has been providing air cover to these psychopaths in Syria and Iraq largely. And we see that when Russia comes in and actually does something constructive, look how long many of these men are shaving their beards and running off with their heads, tails between their legs. It is really, really, really disgusting that people have been conned into thinking that Muslims have anything to do with this. And let us harken back to the original incident which has caused this madness known as the War on Terror. The so-called 19 hijackers in Osama bin Laden is one of the greatest fairy stories ever created. The idea that this man in a cave in Afghanistan on dialysis was masterminding this incredible operation in the United States with 19 so-called hijackers wielding box cutters, Mohammed Atta among them, snorting cocaine and hanging out with strippers in Florida, that these people are responsible for this event in defiance of the greatest military machine in the history of mankind, never mind all of the evidence that's come forward that makes the official version of 9/11 beyond ridiculous. Muslims did not carry out 9/11. In fact, those who blame the Muslims, primarily the Jewish supremacist Zionist-controlled media of America and the government which is controlled by these Jewish supremacist Zionists in America, all of them parrot the same ridiculous, tired old line that Muslims are responsible. And this is an agenda which is intended to create a clash of civilizations. And if we are smart as people, we are going to see the agenda for what it is, and we're going to realize that those who are collaborating in this agenda need to be held to account for literal war crimes and crimes against humanity. And I'm including in that not just the politicians and the military, but those in the media who have perpetuated these lies, because there is no way that they could possibly believe this nonsense. These people have literally sold their soul to the service of the devil.
Let's associate some of those points, Rodney Martin, with some of the points that are happening on the ground and see if there's any connection with the incident that has happened. We're looking at some major gains that have happened in the past 6 weeks. The Russian airstrikes wrong with the Syrian army making advances on the ground with the Iranians in their advisory role. We're looking at the gain that was made in Iraq just yesterday with this area by the name of Sinjar getting liberated. And again, some advances in terms of eradicating these Daesh terrorists. And then you have this incident happen. Do you think that there's any connection? Because we know how much the U.S., Turkey in particular, and Saudi Arabia are so obsessed with pushing Assad out of power. This obsession and what's standing in the way are the forces that have been successful against them, namely Russia, Syrian army, and of course Iran in the advisory role, not to mention Hezbollah and their fighters?
Well, what you see happening is, and this speaks to Mr. O'Keefe's comment about the clash of civilizations, that has been going on, clash of civilizations, since the end of World War I, when the West carved up the Ottoman Empire and decided to dominate and subjugate the people of the Middle East to harvest and steal the natural resources. So that's been going on for quite some time, and it culminated in the creation of the bandit state and the artificial Jewish Zionist state of Israel on the theft of Palestinian land. But you're absolutely correct in looking at the gains and Russia entering the region as a geopolitical and military player to finally bring an end to this archaic nonsense of ISIL, which is the U.S. and Western-created boogeyman. And what you see it as a geopolitical result is the United States is being displaced as a geopolitical player in that region, and not only in Syria, but Iraq. Is now looking towards Russia, giving them airspace operations. And the United States does not like this. Never did in their wildest imagination did they think Russia would operate outside of their boundaries after the fall of the Soviet Union. So what did they do? It's very fishy. I'm not willing at this point, because there's just not enough information on this event to say that the events in Paris, the very tragic events in Paris, you know, have something to do with this, but I sure think the timing is suspicious, and the fact that it was immediately, you know, it was declared to be a Muslim attack. If you look at the U.S. media already, they are declaring this as a Muslim and Islamic attack on Paris. Now, if a group, I know I can go through the history of the last 10 years and cite several incidents where there's been, dare I say, Christian-backed organizations or entities or militias that have engaged in terrorist acts. And you've never heard it called, you know, Christian attack on anything. And like Mr. O'Keefe, I'm a non-Muslim, and I find this absolute treatment of Islamic people to be repulsive and hideous. He's saying that this is a Muslim attack on Western civilization, Western values, when in fact it's in the West that has launched a concerted attack on Islam and Muslims since the end of World War I. And I'm not going to get into the litany of examples. You know, we can talk about the coup in Tehran in 1953. We can talk about the theft of natural resources, intervention and sovereign governments all over the Middle East, and which have subjugated the people of the Middle East and kept them in poverty, you know, separate from their resources, which has sent off to London and Washington, D.C. So I can tell you that the events in Paris today are very, very suspicious. Don't have enough information about it. And for the Western media to declare them to be an Islamic or a Muslim attack is very intellectually dishonest and racist.
Yeah, that has been going on for quite some time. But this is a piece of breaking news that's at the bottom of the screen, Ken O'Keefe, that states it's a message from Assad to Hollande. France suffered on Friday the brutality of terrorism that Syria that has plagued Syria for more than 5 years. That's quite telling in terms of what Syria has experienced. Your reaction to that statement?
Yes, it is truly incredible that we listen to anyone, whether it's Francois Hollande or Obama or any of these other puppets, as if anything they says has any merit whatsoever. There is no moral authority at all in the West. When these people get up, they are an embarrassment to all of us who have a functioning brain and a heart. These people are traitors, whether they come from France or whether they come from Britain or America, and everything they say is to be taken as complete and total rubbish. The idea that France and the West is not directly responsible for the mayhem that has been occurring in Syria is again beyond ridiculous. We know for a fact how we've been supposedly funding and supporting the moderate rebels. There is no such thing. Even recently, a U.S. general admitting that there may be four or five of these people in Syria. The entire policy is intended to create havoc in the Middle East, and it is extremely important that people around the world begin to fully comprehend that these policies that are being carried out in the Middle East are actually not failures. I'm getting sick of hearing so-called experts talking about geopolitics and how America is failing to learn from its mistakes and all of this nonsense. These are not mistakes. These are intentional policies to wreak havoc, to sow the seeds of sectarian hatred. Again, let me cite the fact that before we took Saddam Hussein out in Iraq, there was no al-Qaeda in Iraq. Also, when we played this game in Libya, there was no such thing as ISIS and all of this madness that's going on in Libya today. Syria, again, while it had its problems, and it certainly had its human rights abuses, most definitely did not have the problem that it has today. Every country that we touch in by Western policy, every country that we touch in the Middle East is full of these monsters. Let's look to Iran, the country that we claim to be the biggest threat to everyone. The Israeli Jewish supremacist agenda, which constantly tells us that Iran is the big threat to the world and that it wants to wipe Israel off the map. Let's look at Iran. Let's look how many attacks by al-Qaeda and ISIS are occurring here. Let's look at how Iran has been fighting MEK, a true terrorist force that has killed over 20,000 people in the last 20 years or so. This nation is fighting terrorism legitimately. It has provided sanctuary to Jews and Christians historically over the millennia. It has not indulged in any war for hundreds of years other than the imposed war in which we forced with our attack dog Saddam Hussein, and yet we are being told that Iran is the threat. Here I sit in Tehran, and I can tell you the threat from ISIS is next to none. And the reason why is because Iran is not a player in this nasty game in which Saudi Arabia, Qatar, other Gulf states, Turkey, Jordan, ourselves, Britain, France, all fund, train, support, and ultimately are responsible for these monsters running around in their latest branded name, ISIS, which I will repeat a third time stands for Israeli Secret Intelligence Service.
We're going to end it there. Thank you so much for that. That's Ken O'Keefe, former U.S. Marine, here in the studios with the statements. And also Rodney Martin, thank you, former U.S. Congressional staffer, spoke to us from Los Angeles. Thanks.